The global fertility rate has completely fallen off a cliff. Women are not having kids anymore, guys, and this is a massive problem. The idea here, at least from our tech overlords, is that AI and robotics will save us from this extinction type crisis that we have going on here. And today we're going to explore how and why AI is important in this field and what we need to do as men, as leaders. So let's look at a hard fact here. Back in the 1950s, women were having 4.9 children on average. That number has dropped from 4.9 on average to 2.4. And this is a global number. But what's interesting here is that over half the countries in the world are not even above replacement rate. Half the countries in the world are under 2.1 kids per woman. In the United States, it's even worse at 1.6. We're just not reproducing. We're not replacing ourselves. But the problem doesn't end there with us not having kids. It's that people are living a lot older. In the 1950s, the global average was age 47. And by 2023, the global average is age 73. People are living way longer. In the US, this is also happening. In the US in the 1950s, people were living to about age 68 on average. Now we're living to age 77. So we're not having kids and we're living a lot longer. So just a couple key observations here. Why are we not reproducing? You could blame feminism, social media, maybe it's contraception. Maybe it's just too expensive to have kids. That's not what this video is necessarily about, but I think these are interesting things to talk about and argue about in the comments. That's fine. By the way, some of the comments you guys leave are so lit. I get just the craziest comments. So good, so good. By the way, if you leave a really good comment, I will pin your comment because, you know, I want to highlight the best ideas that are well thought out. Let's also look at why people aren't living longer. It could be capitalism raising people out of poverty. It could be just public health improvements, vaccinations, antibiotics, access to clean food and water. All these things are potentials as to why people are living longer. And again, this video is not necessarily about why this is happening. I just wanted to lay this up in the intro that it is happening. Women and families are not having kids and people are living much longer. And this leads to a couple problems here. What happens is you have these aging populations, they're aging out of the workforce. And this puts a lot of pressure on economic systems, social security and healthcare. I mean, we are running a huge deficit in the United States where, you know, we're having to cover social security for all the elderly people that are aging out, right? But if there's no people in the workforce to pay for the social security for the elderly, how does that work? The answer is the money runs out, inflation goes up, interest rates increase. Massive, massive, massive problems. And what is actually happening is AI and robots are taking over. Technology, once again, is coming into place to save us. And again, you may not like this, but this is happening. I'm going to give you a few examples here today of how AI and robotics are stepping in to solve the problem that is starting to arise. So I was reading an interesting report, an interesting article from Reuters the other day, specifically regarding Japan, because Japan is facing a severe labor shortage. 29% of their population is over 65 and up. So what happens here is you've got, you know, as you get older, you have more health issues, but they don't have the nurses, they don't have the caregivers to handle this. So they have deployed AI-powered robots to act as nursing and companions to compensate for the shortage in healthcare workers. And it's completely transformed their healthcare delivery. And amid this super, super aged out population. I have another example I'll give you too. I'm connected to a guy that has a really cool business. Essentially what it does is he sells companionship to elderly communities and aftercare homes. And how does it work? Well, you sign up as a person for a subscription, and then every day you get a call from an AI companion on your phone. So you're 70 years old, you're tired, you're bored, your brain is starting to slow down. Well, you can get a call from an AI bot that's gonna engage you, and he is crushing it. He's clearing hundreds of thousands of dollars on these tools, on this particular service. And why this is important is, well, when you get older and you're not having engaging conversation anymore, it leads to dementia. Even if you're president of the United States, you're not, quick jab there. It doesn't matter. If you know, it's been proven that if you're engaging with conversations on a regular basis, it improves your cognitive function. And so he's leveraging AI in this regard. So again, this is a real life example that I'm just giving you of how AI is kind of helped serving this role of elderly populations, not enough young people to service and support them. AI and robotics already playing a place. You're seeing it in Japan, you're seeing it in my friend's business to help support and bring companionship to elderly. You could argue that this is a good, you know, this is a bad thing. I'm open to that, but it is happening. It is happening. And I think what's interesting when you look at these populations of people that are 65 plus, again, Japan is at 29%, Canada, 19% of their population is 65 and over, and the US, 17%. China is 14%, so they have a rather young population in the grand scheme of things, which is kind of interesting to me since they had their one child per family policy. But at any rate, that's the numbers that are being reported. And all my links and my resources are down below. I try to research this stuff as thoroughly as I can. I don't just copy and paste from ChatGPT. But another a country that's having an interesting issue is Taiwan. They face a similar issue to Japan with 20% of their population being 65 and over. And they're using AI and robots to proactively monitor health. They're using predictive analytic AI to reduce hospital admissions. And they report that they've reduced hospital admissions up to 30%. So I think that this is a pretty fascinating look as to how AI, technology, data, robotics can reduce the risk of a significant event and help people to live longer and to serve them as healthcare workers can't keep up. Again, if you're not having children, you can't actually support the elderly as they get older. But it doesn't end there. It does not end there. And by the way, if you're enjoying this, you should definitely subscribe to my newsletter, AIUpdate.ai. It is totally free, and I can go more in depth. I can share more stories. I can keep you updated so that you can succeed. But it doesn't stop there, guys. There's more. AI in agriculture. This is already happening, guys. This is not speculation. It's already happening. Companies are using autonomous drones and robotic harvesters to automate labor-intensive tasks. In fact, they're showing increased yields of 15% in Europe and reductions in labor of up to 40%. I mean, this is crazy, guys. And I was watching a video this the other day. It was in Israel. They had this little machine that was rolling around an apple orchard using these little drone suction cup vacuum hands. It looked like a giant octopus, to pluck apples off of trees and drop them in the bucket. You don't need to, you know, this is already happening, guys. The idea of, you know, we need illegal immigrants to come into our country to pick fruit off of trees, it doesn't fly, guys. It doesn't compute. The robots are already doing it. And you might say that's a good thing, you might say it's a bad thing, but it is a thing and it is happening. And you might hate me for saying this stuff. That's fine. You're welcome to your own opinion. You can type in the comments. I'm sure you will. You guys are great at that. I also appreciate you backing me up in the comments too, guys, when I get hate. I love that. But wait, there's more. It doesn't stop there, guys. AI-powered automations are already boosting productivity in warehouses, manufacturing. I recorded a video on this a few weeks ago. I'll put a link to it here. Amazon now has over 1 million robots in their warehouses. If they have not reached this point yet, they are very close to reaching more robots in their warehouses than humans. Guys, robots are already here. They're already, I actually recorded a video on this a year ago about Amazon doing this, and they just hit an inflection point just recently. Again, I'll share that video here, where they've reached 1 million robots in warehouses. And guys, if Amazon's doing it, every company's gonna be doing it. These are ubiquitous, they're everywhere. So you're asking yourself, well, we're not having kids, what are we gonna do? It's already happening. The robots are in the warehouses. 1 million, crazy. And AI in office spaces, guys, I read an article from Deloitte. They expect generative AI to handle 40 to 70% of routine tasks. I'm covering this all the time. Jobs being outsourced. And I know people like to say, oh, it's actually not AI, it's India, or they're covering up for bad for bad quarterly reports or whatever. That's fine that you have that opinion, but I don't know, man. The companies I work for, we're using AI. We are using AI in the companies I work with, and it is great. And it's also, I mean, again, this is already happening, guys. You're seeing, I record a video on this. I'll post a link to it here. The college graduate unemployment rates have skyrocketed this year from 5.8% to 6.6% in just this year. Why? The CEOs, and you might say they're lying, the CEOs are saying, well, we're not hiring interns anymore. We use AI for data entry and for reading and basic entry-level functions. We don't need a human to do it. We'll just use AI. It's already happening. And, you know, I don't want to doom and gloom, you guys, but I do think that when you kind of look at the global structure of humans, reproduction, aging, and then you start to mix AI and robotics in, you can start to see how this new world is coming together. And it's obviously very difficult to predict exactly where the world's going to go, but AI and robots are definitely going to play a major, major role in this equation. And I think it's important to keep in mind here that while we can't predict exactly what the future looks like, we can predict the future is going to have AI and robots. And what is very clear to me is that a lot of the problems that you might be solving now may not exist in the next 5 years. You know, those problems could be solved by AI and automation. But what is going to happen is new problems will arise. And I know this can be exhausting, but it's important to keep in mind that while the problems you might be solving, your job might be doing one thing now, it could change dramatically over the next 5 years. Keep churning, keep adapting, keep reading, keep listening to podcasts like this, keep improving yourself, because the world is changing so dramatically and the challenges are going to be immense, but the opportunities are going to be immense. And the last thing I would say is have more kids, guys. As men, as leaders in this world, we have an obligation to populate the world. Go forth and prosper, have kids. And I know it's easy for me to say I have two kids and we're probably closing up shop. That's my wife's decision. It's kind of her responsibility to close up shop. But regardless, I think we need to have kids. We need to have more kids. Kids are amazing. They bring lots of joy. Guys, if you enjoyed the video, appreciate the like and subscribe. And I think you're really gonna like yesterday's video where I cover Salesforce. You may have heard of them. Salesforce, huge, huge company. And they just laid off 45% of their customer service staff. I'll put a link to it here. 45% of the customer service staff, gone. Why? They're using AI to do those jobs now. And I know what you're gonna say, it's not real, it's fake. I don't know what to tell you, man. They just laid off a bunch of people and they said they're using AI. So check out the video. I'll see you there. Peace.